The worst tragedy ever in Indonesia's football history happened in early of October when 135 people were killed in the Kanjuruhan Stampede tragedy in Malang, East Java. The tragedy is recorded as the world's second largest football tragedy due to number of fatalities.
October 1st, 2022 became Indonesia's biggest disaster in sports that also marked the dark history of the country's football history. Hundreds of people were trapped inside Kanjuruhan Stadium, situated in Malang, East Java, after East Java derby match at Indonesian Premier League Liga 1 between host city's soccer club Arema FC and Surabaya's Persebaya Surabaya. The match that was held on Saturday evening without the presence of supporters from Persebaya Surabaya ended with the win of Persebaya 3-2. That's also the first Persebaya's victory in Arema FC, or popular known as Singo Edan's camp, in the last 23 years. Disappointed supporters of Arema, known as Aremania, whom refused to accept its beloved team defeated, one by one went to the field at the end of the match, trying to approach Arema's team officials and players. It triggered security personnel to take prevention measures that caused clashes with the supporters when trying to disperse the crowd. Police also spread tear gases to disperse the crowd. Tear gas shooting had caused the situation was out of control. Police personnel shot tear gases not only to the crowd in the middle of the soccer field, but also toward packed spectators whom sat in tribune, caused them panic. They tried to escape the tribune altogether in the same to the exits that caused the deadly stampede. The use of tear gas to disperse the crowd during a soccer match at Kanjuruhan Stadium at the time has become controversy as FIFA forbids it. Citing an official FIFA document on safety and security, the governing body's Article 19B that's overseeing pitch side stewards states that no firearms and crowd control gas shall be carried or used. The stampede has claimed hundreds of lives. Shortly after the Kanjuruhan stampede, more than 100 people were confirmed had died and hundreds of others wounded. Those victims had been taken to 3 nearby hospitals for emergency treatments. The following day, President Joko Widodo conveyed his condolences and regret over the football tragedy that after 24 hours from it happened had caused the death of 130 people. President Widodo had immediately ordered responsible parties to evaluate the tragedy comprehensively.
Saya juga telah perintahkan kepada Menpora, Kapolri dan Ketua Umum PSSI untuk melakukan evaluasi menyeluruh tentang pelaksanaan pertandingan sepak bola dan juga prosedur pengamanan penyelenggaraannya. Khusus kepada Kapolri, saya minta melakukan investigasi dan mengusut tuntas kasus ini. Untuk itu, saya juga memerintahkan PSSI untuk menghentikan sementara Liga 1 sampai evaluasi dan perbaikan prosedur pengamanan dilakukan. Saya menyesalkan terjadinya tragedi ini dan saya berharap ini adalah tragedi terakhir sepak bola di tanah air. Jangan sampai ada lagi tragedi kemanusiaan seperti ini di masa yang akan datang.
The Indonesian National Police team from Inavis Unit and Forensic Lab investigate the crime scene after the incident. The crime scene investigation was closed for public, aimed to immediately discover the cause of the tragedy. Meanwhile, the government of Indonesia formed an independent joint fact-finding team, TGIPF, that's led by Coordinating Minister for Political, Legal and Security Affairs, Mahfud MD. The TGIPF was work under and responsible to the president. The team was given mandate to work within 1 month since it was established. Presiden Widodo visit Dr. Saiful Anwar Regional Hospital in Malang City, East Java to monitor the condition of the victims of the Kanjuruhan tragedy. The president explained that his visit was to ensure that the survivors had received the best treatments, adding that the treatment costs will be entirely covered by the government.
Saya benar-benar ingin tahu akar masalah penyebab tragedi ini sehingga ke depan kita bisa mendapatkan sebuah solusi terbaik. Tadi saya juga menyampaikan kepada para pasien korban bahwa seluruh biaya untuk perawatan ditanggung oleh pemerintah dan pemerintah daerah.
Separately, Chairman of the PSSI, Muhammad Iriawan, visited the crime scene at Kanjuruhan Stadium. The top official of PSSI had directly inspected the stadium's gate that were reported were closed when the incident took place. 5 days after the Kanjuruhan tragedy happened, the Indonesian National Police declared 6 people as suspects. 3 suspects are civilians, including Ahmad Hadian Lukita, CEO of Liga Indonesia Baru, the organizer of Indonesia's Premier League Liga 1, while 3 other suspects from security personnel, including Police Commissioner Wahyu Setio Pranoto, Head of Operational Division of Malang Police Office. Despite the 6 suspects, 20 other police personnel were announced had violating police ethical code when conducted their duties of securing Kanjuruhan Stadium. 2 weeks after TGIPF working, Coordinating Minister for Political, Legal and Security Affairs, Mahfud MD, announced the result of their investigation. The conclusion was the cause of the mass death in the Kanjuruhan tragedy is prominently by tear gas.
Yang mati dan cacat serta sekarang kritis dipastikan itu terjadi karena desak-desakan setelah ada gas air mata yang disemprotkan. Itu penyebabnya.
The team also gave some recommendation to President Widodo, such as about parties who responsible over the Kanjuruhan tragedy, which include PSSI and its sub-organizations, must take responsibility over the tragedy legally and morally. Meanwhile, Farzah Dwi Kurniawan, a victim of the Kanjuruhan tragedy, has left his last breath on October 23rd. Farzah was the 135th victim after treating at Saiful Anwar Hospital in Malang for 22 days. Victims' family from the Kanjuruhan tragedy keep demanding justice. The waves of protests to demand comprehensive investigation and punishment for responsible parties are continued in various locations as part of solidarity actions to the victims. They hope that there will be additional suspects and articles on murder and premeditated murder from the Indonesian Criminal Code can be added in the tragedy that's seen not only as the matter of negligence. In the meantime, PSSI admitted that it has done football transformation following the Kanjuruhan tragedy by fixing several aspects, such as fixing stadium to meet FIFA standard, fixing supporter management to security management.
Kejadian Kanjuruhan memang suatu hal yang tidak diinginkan, tapi dari kejadian tersebut kita harus mengambil perbaikan yang secara maksimal di sana sini di seluruh item yang ada. Semuanya menjadi perbaikan yang harus dilakukan, ya. Bukan dari PSSI saja, dari semua sektor, ya. Karena sana juga ada stadion, ada supporter, kemudian ada pihak pengamanan, ada pihak security lain sebagainya. Insya Allah Indonesia nanti akan menjadi negara dengan sepak bola yang cukup baik.
The Kanjuruhan tragedy that has claimed 135 lives has become the world's second largest football tragedy after tragedy at Estadio Nacional Peru in 1964 that caused 328 fatalities.